Hi, I'm Tim, and I would like to give you an introduction to our MicroLabbox 2. Let's start with a quick unboxing so you know what to expect when ordering a MicroLabbox 2. The system is delivered with a handy bag that's great for carrying it around or storing it when not in use. Additionally, you can keep all required cables and connectors in the compartment on the bag. Inside, we find the system itself, in this case, a top panel variant that has, as its name suggests, the connectors on top. We also offer a front panel variant with connectors on the front, which allows you to stack other equipment or multiple MicroLabboxes. Apart from that, both variants are technically identical. Before going into further details, I would like to quickly explain what the MicroLabbox 2 can be used for. In principle, the system is used to execute software, mostly Simulink models, in a deterministic real-time environment, while providing a lot of digital and analog channels that let you connect your model to real-world signals. This is extremely useful if, for instance, you are developing a control algorithm in Simulink and want to see how it behaves with the real mechatronic system connected, which is what we call rapid control prototyping. Or, if you're a test engineer, you can connect your controller hardware, like an ECU, and use the MicroLabbox 2 to execute a planned model of the system to be controlled for hardware-in-the-loop testing. In order to execute models with high real-time performance, the MicroLabbox 2 uses two separate processors and dedicates one of them exclusively to the execution of the model, without being interrupted by other tasks. This quad-core processor can achieve task turnaround times in the microsecond range. And if that is still not fast enough, you can even offload parts of your model to the integrated Kintec UltraScale Plus FPGA. This is extremely useful for high-fidelity simulation models or very fast control algorithms. Of course, model calculation speed is important, but we want to work with real-world signals, so we also need fast, high-resolution input and output channels. In this domain, the MicroLabbox 2 has a lot to offer. It provides 32 analog input channels and 16 analog output channels with a sampling rate of up to 5 megasamples per second. On the top panel variant, we use BNC connectors for highest analog signal integrity, while the front panel variant uses sub-D connectors for all I/O channels. In terms of digital channels, the MicroLabbox 2 has 50 bidirectional channels that can be used for PWM signals with a minimum pulse width of 25 nanoseconds. In addition to the analog and digital channels, you get 4 CAN-FD channels with signal improvement capability, 4 LIN channels, and 2 UARTs. On the back, you find 2 real-time capable 10 gigabit Ethernet ports, alongside a 1 gigabit Ethernet port that is used to connect the system to your PC. Furthermore, the backside hosts the sensor supply that outputs 12 volts and 5 volts via banana plugs, so you don't have to keep a separate power supply on your desk. There's also a USB port for data logging and a DSpace IOCNet connector that can be used to attach further I/O modules if required. Last but not least, the optical MGT port gives you direct access to the FPGA's multi-gigabit transceivers. So, as you can see, the MicroLabbox 2 is packed with a lot of processing power, accompanied by an FPGA and a large variety of I/O and communication interfaces, and yet it doesn't need more space than a notebook on your desk. I've talked a lot about the hardware now. But in order to actually work with the hardware, of course, you also need proper software to go with it. This is where our comprehensive DSpace toolchain comes into play. The MicroLabbox 2 works with our implementation tool, Configuration Desk. All hardware-related things, like I/O channel assignment and the specification of what functionality a channel shall provide, are done within Configuration Desk, which results in a clear separation between the hardware configuration and your Simulink model. This approach gives you the flexibility to modify or exchange your model without having to reconfigure the I/O. And as soon as your application is running, Our experiment and instrumentation software Control Desk lets you perform measurements and visualize the data during one time so you can quickly see if everything performs as expected. You can even use it to change parameters of your Simulink model on the fly without having to recompile anything. Of course, our software portfolio contains many more tools for things like test automation, bus inspection, etc., but explaining those would be too much for this video. So I hope this short overview of the MicroLabbox 2's features and capabilities caught your interest. If all this sounds interesting to you, me and my colleagues are always glad to get in touch with you and, of course, everything I just mentioned and a lot more information can be found at dspace.com or via this QR code printed onto the enclosure. Have a great day and see you soon.
DSpace, your partner in simulation and validation.